Today, we're going to be migrating MailerLite Classic into the newest MailerLite. My name is Adam Jones, the owner of Pullman Marketing, and we end up doing these types of processes as an agency for clients all the time. The main reason you'll be looking at doing this is because they're eventually going to get rid of the old MailerLite system in favor of the newer one, which does have faster workflows, new graphics, have a new UI flow. The item that we're most excited about is the multi-trigger automation system. This is a huge leap forward in maturity of the product, and we are very excited for that end of it. So let's get started. Once you log in, you will be greeted by a new dashboard area, which shows that there are two versions, the new one and the classic. And we're gonna go ahead and hop into the classic one first. This is a live environment, and so as a reminder, there is real data that you're gonna be seeing. This is a process that we did ourselves, and just showing what a real-world environment will look like. To start, click on the top right, and then click on Integrations. And there you want to hit the Developer API. Try not to get confused with some of the other items. There are a lot of things, but it's gonna be right at the top is that Developer API. Go ahead and click that, and hit Copy the API key. And we're gonna set that into a separate notepad for safekeeping just for now. Once you have that API key safe, go ahead and use this icon in the top area, and that will take us back to the dashboard switcher area. All right, now go ahead and select the new MailerLite, and it may request you to create a new password. Go ahead and work on that if that does pop up. Once you're logged into the new system, it may ask you to create an account. Go ahead and name it appropriately just so you know what one's the old one and what one's the new one. On the dashboard itself, there is a notification about migrating. Go ahead and click on the Migrate account on the right side. And this is where we will input that API key from earlier. Go ahead and hit confirm and migrate. And hopefully it will say it was successful. In our use case, it was. The next step is to migrate your subscribers over. So we're gonna go ahead and look on that right side, click on the Migrate More button. If it says you cannot migrate subscribers in your current plan, do remember that these are essentially two separate platforms with two separate subscription fees. At this time, go ahead and upgrade the plan on the new MailerLite system by clicking the Upgrade Your Plan button. We chose the Growing Business Plan for the additional auto resend campaign function. This is absolutely worth the $10 a month alone, along with the 24/7 email support. If you feel like you need more support with a larger account, we do recommend the advanced plan for the 24/7 chat. It does connect you to real humans, which we do like, and we have gotten good support in the past. Once upgraded, you will be brought back to the dashboard and click Migrate More, once again on that right side. Now, at time of filming, they were only allowing for the importing of subscribers, but hopefully they will soon have more imports available. For importing those subscribers that you have, click on the Proceed button on that right side. A dialog pop-up will ask to confirm the account you are pulling from, and once you have confirmed that it is the correct account, maybe you have multiple classic accounts, go ahead and click on that Start Migration. Once that is complete, double-check your settings and even your company profile. As you can see, it missed our state field, and on the other page, our Facebook link went missing. So we did have to go ahead and add that back in. For domains, for that tab, please do check that you are still verified. If this does go away, please, 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 for deliverability, make sure that you are an authenticated domain. Double check everything as you go. After all that is said and done, we do recommend sending a quick test email to your internal audience of staff to make sure that it's all working as needed. So at this point, you should have a fully migrated MailerLite new account. If you had any errors during the migration process or if you had questions, go ahead and let us know in the comments. For the most part, we've done this migration several times and haven't run into any errors, but hey, maybe something happened. It's computers, right? If you found this content helpful, please hit the subscribe button, hit the bell, tell us what you thought in the comments below, and have a wonderful day. This was fun. We should do this more often. For more information on the differences between MailerLite Classic and MailerLite, go ahead and check out the link in our description down below. It goes right to the MailerLite blog, and it has a lot of those kind of comparisons and cross-feature sets.